Hi, I'm Alex, and welcome to Super Make Something. Today, we're making a DIY Stream Deck. Let's get started. This episode is sponsored by PCB Way. Follow the link in the video description below to order your own set of circuit boards needed to build this project. Because of the ongoing pandemic, the number of people interested in creating live stream content has increased dramatically. Arguably, one of the best streaming tools besides a camera, microphone, and lights is an Elgato Stream Deck, a macro keyboard with an LCD screen behind the buttons, which allows users to program custom shortcuts to control their streaming software and various other applications. Unfortunately, the surge in interest has made these devices either difficult to find or very expensive. Because of this, I decided to create an open source version, which will hopefully make it easier for those interested in streaming to go live online, and to make it possible for individuals to create the custom Stream Deck that best suits their streaming needs. The main idea behind this project is that anyone can build it, even if they don't have any electronics experience. Because of this, the design is guided by the following rules. 1. All electronic parts should be easily available online from vendors where everyone already shops, like Amazon or AliExpress. 2. The design should use pre-made electronics assemblies wherever possible, meaning no individual chips. 3. Common parts like resistors and LEDs should be through-hole instead of surface mount for easier soldering. And 4. The total price of all components in the bill of materials should cost no more than the price of an official Stream Deck. When I started this project, I didn't know if meeting this last rule would be possible, so to keep track, a running total of the cost of all materials in one Stream Deck will be displayed on the side of the screen. This number may vary a bit for you depending on where you purchase your components from and the minimum number of each type of component you'll be able to buy, since some items, like push buttons, often come in packs of 50, which is more than enough to build one Stream Deck. Links to all components needed to build this project can be found in the video description below. Based on these rules, the open source Stream Deck is designed around a 3.5-inch color LCD screen and an Arduino Pro Micro microcontroller. Using this microcontroller is important because it is small and uses the Atmega32U4 chip, which can emulate a USB keyboard. Based on the screen size, I decided that my Stream Deck would have 6 programmable keys, as well as 2 rotary encoders, which the official Stream Deck does not have. While the encoders won't have an LCD screen underneath them, they do each have another push button and will be handy for me during video editing because they'll allow me to quickly scrub through a video and adjust audio levels. I decided to begin this project with the electronics. Because the LCD screen has no internal memory, icons for the Stream Deck are stored on an SD card, which interfaces with the LCD screen through an SD card reader. Unfortunately, the Pro Micro does not have enough input-output pins to connect to both these components and sense button inputs, so I added another microcontroller, an Arduino Pro Mini, to the design in order to handle loading icon images and displaying them on the LCD screen. This essentially separates the hardware for this project into two parts, one which is responsible for handling all of the display tasks, and one which simply senses button inputs and sends USB keyboard commands. However, since I wanted the Stream Deck to be able to store more shortcuts than the number of physical keys on the device, both microcontrollers need to be able to coordinate when a folder button is pressed, which both loads a new set of icons and changes the keyboard commands that are sent by each button. To accomplish this, one input-output pin of each Arduino is connected together, which can be used to send signals back and forth between the microcontrollers to coordinate what keyboard shortcuts and button icons should currently be active. This project has a lot of interconnected components, so it'd be impractical to wire everything by hand. To make the project more robust and more easily reproducible, I therefore decided to create a set of printed circuit boards for the Stream Deck using the PCB design software Eagle. While the details of using Eagle are outside of the scope of this video, the PCB design process essentially boils down to placing the components that you would like to use into a schematic and connecting them together appropriately using virtual wires. After the schematic is wired up, it's then necessary to physically lay out the components on a virtual circuit board to describe how the board should be manufactured. In this design, the Arduinos, SD card reader, and LCD screen mount to a motherboard PCB, and the components to sense all of the inputs are connected to a second button PCB, which has square windows milled into it in order to be able to see the icons displayed on the LCD screen. During the final assembly, these circuit boards are then connected together using a wire ribbon cable. Once the physical layout of the boards was complete, it was time to create a set of Gerber files which would let the circuit board fabricator know how to manufacture each board. After zipping everything up, I headed to PCBWay.com, who I used to make these circuit boards, and uploaded my files to their online system. PCB Way offers various types of PCB fabrication services for any budget, depending on the options you choose when you upload your files. Because my boards had an exposed logo, and I wanted to show them off in the final build, I opted for a black solder mask and an Enig finish, which covers all of the exposed contacts with a thin layer of gold. In case you're interested in ordering these boards for yourself, a link to the Gerber files can be found in the video description below. The video description also contains a link to the PCBWay Community Shared Project Store, where you can order the exact same boards that I used for this build with a single click. Less than a week after submitting my order, I received my boards in the mail, and the quality was awesome. The silkscreen text describing each connection was super crisp, and the gold-plated Super Make Something logos came out perfectly. After about 30 minutes of soldering, I had two awesome-looking circuit boards that were ready for programming. While I waited for the circuit boards to arrive, I designed and 3D printed the Stream Deck's mechanical components. The cool thing about Eagle is that it's made by Autodesk, who also make the Fusion 360 3D modeling software. Because of this, full 3D models of the assembled circuit boards can be imported into Fusion 360, which made it incredibly easy to design an enclosure around the project's electronics. In my Stream Deck design, an LCD screen is located underneath the button PCB. Each Stream Deck key is made up of a 3D printed button frame with a clear acrylic insert. These each sit on top of four push buttons on the button PCB, which creates a rugged, simple mechanical button mechanism without needing to purchase other components like springs. The four buttons underneath each key are wired in parallel to ensure that input will register no matter how a Stream Deck key is pressed. To make the Stream Deck look a little cooler, I used Fusion 360's Voronoi sketch generator to cut a cool pattern into all of the surfaces of the enclosure I designed, which not only saved some material, but also made everything print a little faster. In case a normal box is more your style, I also created a model without holes that you can use instead. Once I was happy with the overall design, I exported each model as an STL file and opened them in Cura, a free 3D slicing program which generates instructions for a 3D printer about how to create each part. After configuring all of the print options, I sliced each model, which generated the print instructions in a format known as G-code, and saved these to an SD card. All of the files are printed on an ET4 Pro, a desktop 3D printer made by ANet. The printer comes as a kit that is mostly pre-assembled, which can be out of the box and up and running in less than 10 minutes. The printer has a 220x220x250mm build volume and includes multiple advanced features like silent stepper motor drivers, automatic bed leveling, filament runout detection, and power loss resume functionality. Sticking with the open source nature of this project, the printer can now also run the open source Marlin printer firmware, which is awesome for advanced users to further customize their machine. Best of all, the printer is often available online for under $200. For those looking for a machine with a larger build volume, ANet also makes the ET5 Pro, which has the same features as its smaller sibling, but can print models up to 300x300x400mm. Be sure to check out both of these machines by following the links in the video description below. After about 19 hours, the printer made 11 parts. One Stream Deck base, one Stream Deck spacer insert, one Stream Deck top cover, two encoder knobs, and six button frames. With all of the parts done printing, it was now time to program the electronics. I began by heading to arduino.cc and downloading and installing the Arduino programming environment. I next headed to the Super Make Something GitHub site, where I then went to the open source Stream Deck page and downloaded all of the project code as a zip file. After extracting the contents of this folder, I copied the lcdwiki_GUI and lcdwiki_KBV folders into the directory shown on screen. I then copied the Arduino TFT_icons and Stream Deck keyboard folders onto my hard drive where I could easily find them later. As stated earlier, the Stream Deck uses separate Arduinos to emulate a keyboard and display icons on the LCD screen, so they must be programmed separately. After plugging the Arduino Nano into my computer with a mini USB connector, I first opened the Arduino TFT_icons.ino file to program the Arduino driving the LCD screen. In the Arduino IDE, I then headed to Tools Board and made sure that the Arduino Nano option was selected, and then went to Tools Processor and made sure that the Atmega328P old bootloader option was checked. After verifying that the right COM port was selected, I then clicked the Upload button, which compiled the code and uploaded it to the Arduino Nano. Next, it was time to program the Arduino Pro Micro. For this, I first connected the microcontroller to my computer using a micro USB cable and then opened up the streamdeckkeyboard.ino file. Next, I headed to Tools Board and selected the Arduino Leonardo option. After verifying that I had selected the correct COM port, I again clicked Upload, which compiled the code and uploaded it to the Arduino Pro Micro. One thing to note is that the power lines of both Arduinos are connected together, so it's only necessary to plug in the micro USB cable into the Arduino Pro Micro to connect the Stream Deck to the computer after assembly. Now that the Arduinos were fully programmed, it was time to put everything together. I first attached the SD card reader to the 3D printed base using two M2 screws. Next, I carefully inserted the motherboard PCB into the base and attached it using three M3 screws. I then carefully inserted the pins of the LCD screen into the female header pins on the motherboard PCB in the orientation shown on screen. I then inserted the spacer insert into the matching recess in the base, and then attached the keyboard PCB to it using four more M3 screws. After this, I gently pressed a 20x20mm square acrylic piece that I had purchased online into each button frame, and then laid them over each of the button slots as shown. After this, I placed the top cover over the buttons to keep everything together, which attached the 3D printed base with four more M3 screws, and finally pressed the two 3D printed knobs onto the encoders, after which the Stream Deck assembly was complete. The final step was to create icons that would be displayed on the LCD screen. For this, I created a Photoshop template, which can be downloaded from the Super Make Something GitHub page. Each icon is 120 by 120 pixels and can be filled however you want, as long as the icon files are saved as 24-bit BMP files. Because of the screen orientation inside of the Stream Deck, the icons also need to be rotated onto their side. The file name of each icon corresponds to which Stream Deck key they will display under, with numbers larger than 6 indicating that this icon will be displayed on the second page. To add more pages, simply modify the Arduino code by copying the corresponding if statements and changing the file names and desired keyboard shortcuts. Be sure to check out the Arduino code for an example of how to do this. After creating all of the icons, I saved the files to an SD card and inserted it into the SD card reader on the bottom of the Stream Deck base, after which the only thing that was left to do was to map the keyboard stroke sent by the device into OBS, Streamlabs, or any other software that I wanted to use it with. I actually used the Stream Deck to edit this video in Sony Vegas, and it worked extremely well because the encoders were handy for quickly and precisely scrubbing through my editing timeline. The final price also came in at less than an official Stream Deck while adding more functionality, so this project was a huge success. Since I've built this project, the DIY Stream Deck has been a permanent fixture on my desk, and I use it for many tasks, including streaming, video editing, and gaming. Overall, I'm very happy with how the Stream Deck turned out, but there are several ways that this project could be improved. First, the clock speed of the Arduino was a bit low, meaning that it takes several seconds for all of the icons to redraw on the LCD screen after a folder button is pressed. Switching it out with a different microcontroller, like the STM32 Blue Pill board, could help speed up this process significantly. Using a microcontroller with more I/O pins would also make it possible to build this project with a single board and allow the SD card reader integrated on the back of the LCD screen to be used, both of which would make the DIY Stream Deck smaller. However, trade-offs exist because other boards can be harder to program than an Arduino, which would make it more difficult for people who aren't familiar with electronics to build one of these Stream Decks for themselves. A big shout out to PCBWay and ANet for supplying many of the materials that I needed to build this project. All of the design files for this project are available for free at the links in the video description so that you can make your own DIY Stream Deck. My hope is that others will use these files to create evolutions of the design, and that the DIY Stream Deck will grow into an open source project that is widely supported by the electronics community. If you liked this build and found it useful, please consider giving the video a like, sharing it with your friends, and subscribing to my channel. If you want to support future builds like this, please also consider becoming a patron. Well, that's all there is to this episode. Thanks for watching. Now go super make something.